decided on May 20th, and I will try a second one, second chance. I will try to do this. And of course, thank you, Team Haney, for giving me this chance. And that's it. We're all prepared for this.
Like Ike said, when he made that phone call to you and you decided to decline that opportunity to stay in Ukraine, were you confident, or did you feel like, you know, that you would ever get the opportunity to fight for Undisputed again? Or at that point, I'm sure boxing wasn't on your mind, but did you hope that this opportunity would come back around?
Well, you can think about the future, then war come to your house. You just thinking about life and about your family and about your people who are around you. And you just thinking about how you can live next day. And you can thinking about your job, about your sport or professional sport or something else. You're just thinking about your defense.
Like boxing is just a game. You know, you win, you lose, it's a sport. But what Vasily did, putting a uniform on, getting a gun, ready to defend his countrymen, that is a whole different level. Because it's not a game, but it's not a sport, it's life and death. And he was getting through that, and thank God he's with us here today.
And you've also been able to get another fight under your belt since having the 10-month layoff to come back. You beat Jermaine Ortiz, a tough opponent, a bigger opponent, coming off of that layoff. And now, coming into this fight with Devin, you said that you respect his boxing IQ. A lot of people are dubbing this fight like a chess match. As you can see by the art that's been presented, the poster, fantastic job to the team on that, and the whole promo for this what many consider to be a chess match. So how do you view this matchup, being that he does have such a good boxing IQ?
We all never know what happened. We can prepare for one strategy, but in the ring, it will all change. Can we all change? And right now, I don't know. I just train hard, I prepare, and I believe in God and I believe in my team.
And your team and your father, we talked a little bit about this before the press conference got started. He's trained by his father. They're going to take it to another level because they know what's at stake. I would have to imagine that you and your father are going to take things to another level in preparation for what could be, you know, an extremely tough match against Devin Haney. The changes in that you're going to make in this training camp based on the opposition?
Look, you know, for me, it looks like I prepare for first Olympic Games. I go to bed with this dream, I wake up with this dream, I live with this dream. And of course, we train hard to prepare this, and it's a big motivation.
You're preparing like you did for a gold medal. Lastly, before I get to Devin, if I can just ask you, what a win in this fight would mean to your legacy. You've had an extremely successful amateur career. You've won belts in three different weight classes. You've won multiple gold medals. What would Undisputed champion mean to Vasily Lomachenko and your family?
It looks like then you put a goal and take a goal. After then you take a goal, of course you're very, very happy. And you know, you do what you want. That's my mind.
But this is kind of the last thing that you feel like you haven't accomplished that you want to accomplish. So it has to mean a little bit more to you than just another fight.
Look, it's a It's a dream from the beginning. Then I came in professional sports. No, I can explain about my emotions right now because I am not an undisputed world champion. That's why.
I got you. So we'll talk about it if you know
after the fight.
But he has other plans. This gentleman right here to my right, and Devin Haney, and for you, Devin, like your dad said, better late than never. Right. I mean, you wanted this opportunity since 2019, I believe, and now we are here. Why was it important for you to stay at 135 and defend your titles for the second time against this man's world?
First off, I want to thank God Allah, you know, for everything, this opportunity. I'm blessed to be here. Something else that I've always dreamed of. Like you said, I've been winning this fight since 2019. I've been begging for it, calling for it. The time has finally came. You know, the tables have turned this time around. You know, when he had the belts, he wouldn't fight me. He wouldn't fight me. But you know, it's a fight that I truly believe. I truly believe that I'm a better fighter, and a better competitor. And rather 4 years ago or now, I will be victorious. So I'm happy that the time has finally came.
Taking this fight against Vasily Lomachenko, what do you feel like having a name like him on your resume? Obviously, you guys are students of the game. You know everybody that he's fought. Your dad said he's been watching his tape for a long time. Why him? Why was he an important opponent for you?
Yeah, this is a legacy fight for me. You know, Loma at one time was number one pound for pound. A few months ago, he was higher than me on the pound for pound level. And now that fight is getting made or has been made, he's dropped down off the pound for pound list. But it is what it is. We know what type of fighter he is. We know that he deserves to be on the pound for pound list. Not above me, but definitely on the pound for pound list. So it's just a legacy fight. This is a fight. This is a real fight. This is not like an influencer or, you know, this is really for the pound. This is really for the goal, everything, the pound for pound, the best in the business. Possibly the best in the world.
But haven't you been clamoring for a fight like this? Aren't you tired of hearing like people, you know, questioning things? You know what you're capable of. You're just waiting for the opportunity for somebody to be able to bring all that out. Because I have a feeling we have not yet seen everything that you have in your arsenal. And it takes a fighter like this, an opponent like this, to bring some of those things out. Am I correct in saying that?
Yeah, I mean, the better the opposition, the better, you know, I am as a fighter, the more I rise. Loma is a good fighter, but I'm just on a totally different level. And on a fight night, the world will see that. The world will see how good Devin Haney really is.
Do you see it as a chess match? I mean, obviously this fight has boxing fans like purists, like drooling at the opportunity to see you guys in there. Do you see it like a tactical chess match? Or you kind of, I'm sure you envision how the fight's gonna go in your head. How do you kind of see it playing out?
I gotta see. I don't know. I never shared the ring with him yet, so I don't know what type of fighter he is, how good he really is. Is he what they say on paper? Yes, definitely. He's definitely shown against different opponents. He rolls to the cage on you know every night that he stepped in there. He showed a high IQ, but I'm just a totally different fighter. I'm on a totally different level. So it may be a chess match, may not. It may not be. I may just walk through him. We gotta see.
Those people wondering kind of like your training techniques. I know you're observing Ramadan right now, and how does that kind of change your training or your preparation for this fight?
Ramadan is now, so we've been training at nighttime, you know, when the sun down, you know, my team, you know, most of my team is Muslim as well, so everyone is fasting. I was fasting, I'm not fasting anymore, because it's just too hard to train, you know, 2-3 sessions in. Fueled for those sessions, but the rest of my teammates, so we're training, we're about to train at night time. Even we fight at night time, so it's okay. But it's you know, we receive so many blessings, you know, during Ramadan, during Ramadan, so I'm happy that this fight is coming after Ramadan. Even though I wasn't able to force the lack of fast and that, I'm happy that it has came after Ramadan.
And that one of those blessings is the fact that this fight is happening in Las Vegas. You're headlining your first pay-per-view. I remember you fighting on, Pacquiao undercard against Bradley, Pacquiao Bradley 3, and you on an undercard. And now in the same building, you're coming back, and you're headlining a pay-per-view. I mean, it's crazy how things kind of come full circle, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, alhamdulillah for that. You know, I'm so blessed to, you know, TG Fighting and Jimmy Craig, for all the belts, for any student, you know, for everything. It's such a blessing. It's something that I've worked so hard for. I knew that I would be in a position. You know, it came fast. I'm just 24 years old, but I was ready for it. And May 20th, I will be ready for it, whatever room it brings.
All right, before we let these guys do their official first face-off, the pay-per-view undercard, $59.99, priced excellent compared to some of the other pay-per-views out there. Some good talents on our undercard as well. Oscar Valdez, you want to talk a little bit about what else we have to present on that pay-per-view?
No, the pay-per-view card will be sensational. There is a debate of what is the appropriate price. Now, it seems that the pay-per-view universe, the number of people willing to buy the pay-per-view, hasn't expanded. And so the tendency of promoters and network are to raise the prices. And it really puts an event outside of the ability of fans to pay. So we decided that a good solution was to go for a price of approximately $60 try to make up for that by getting more people interested in buying the pay-per-view, and so we wouldn't really be the loser because of that, and we would help boxing. Now, you can't really criticize people that are charging $85 or $90. That's their choice. They're looking at a shrinking fan base who buy pay-per-view, and so by raising the prices, they keep, they don't get hit with the money loss. But I think we studied this with ESPN, and we determined that this fight had enough interest that if we went with a ticket price that was less than what everybody else was charging, that we would make up for it by an increased number of buys. Now, whether that happens or doesn't happen remains to be seen. All I know is if anybody calls themselves a boxing fan, they have to watch this fight. And that's the determination we made in setting the price for the pay-per-view.
Once again, to watch this fight, May 20th from the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Tickets go on sale tomorrow via AXS.com. I mean, 10 a.m. Pacific time, tickets will go on sale. It'll be available exclusively in the U.S. on ESPN Plus digitally, and also available on your local cable and satellite providers. Vegas, Mama, thank you so much for being here with us today, Bob. I appreciate you, Bill, and Devin. Thank you so much.
Bob, is Lomachenko one of the best fighters that you've seen since Muhammad Ali and Sugar Ray? Still, Mr. Aaron?
Absolutely. I mean, I knew that when he came with us out of the amateurs. Nobody that I know had the amateur credentials as a silver champion.
And that's why we want to fight.
And he was able to take those skills and go into the professional ranks with great success.
When you made that comment, that's when we decided that Lomachenko was the fighter that we really wanted. You've done a wonderful job of promoting Brazil. And when you made that statement as a Hall of Fame promoter, there was no other fight that we wanted as a team. So thank you for making it happen.
No, thank you. a sellout, and we expect it to happen very quickly. So everybody should tell all your followers to get their tickets because there'll be a tremendous demand for seats to this fight.
I can add one more thing, if I could. I can add one more thing. I know for a fact, Loma is the only one boxer in nowadays who sold, Bob can tell me to tell if I'm wrong, Loma is the only one who sold arenas in the different countries and in the different cities. We started with Acrova, the right now is the crypto arena was sold out. We went to New York to fight Linares, Madison Square was sold out. We went to London, O2 Arena, it was officially sold out.
Biggie's, we ran you all around the world. You were running from us.
It's not about money from here. It's not about selling tickets. It's not about none of that.
It is about selling tickets. So are we. For all these people to talk to you guys. So I won't hold you up any longer. Evan, are you going to do the honors of closing the fight? I'm Christina Ponder. Thank you all again for joining with us. Apologize for the delay today. And we're going to let these guys face off. And we'll see you May 20th. Bye-bye.
Gosh, get out the fucking room.
Everybody face him right there. Face off. Face forward first. Right there.